Hi gang, I'm glad you're all here. Thank you for joining me. USGS said there was a 5.5 earthquake there on the western side of the Tonga Trench. Geoscope said it was a magnitude 6.0. EMSC said it was also a 6.0. They said it was 200 kilometers in depth, which would be about 120 miles below sea level. And all earthquakes are measured from sea level. USGS said it was 159 kilometers, which would be about 98 miles or almost 99 miles below sea level. Going to Google Earth, here's the location of the 6.0. This here is the Tonga Trench. Scientists now believe that these deep earthquakes are caused by the water coming up, being sucked down as you have the subduction of the Pacific plate, going underneath the Australian plate. In this area, subduction is fairly rapid, about 9.4 inches a year. Another interesting thing about the Tonga Trench, it's actually subducting faster at the northern end than what it is at the southern end. They also found that the faster the slab moves, the deeper the earthquakes are. They think it's because the plate, the crust of the earth that's subducting, doesn't have a longer time to melt. And it's being forced down quicker, less time to melt, thus creating the earthquakes. The seawater that's also being subducted along with the earth's crust has a shorter time to evaporate. So that seawater coming in contact with the mantle is also causing earthquakes, causing the crust to rupture and fracture, and also causing these earthquakes. So I thought that would be something to look at when you're looking at the different earthquakes around the world, where they're having deep earthquakes. Here's an example, a 3.3 that happened up there in Alaska. That was 111 kilometers in depth. We know that's an area of subduction. Here we got a 2.7. That was 96.8 kilometers in depth. In Peru, a magnitude 4.1, that was 123 kilometers in depth. In Pampa, Argentina, there was a 6.0, 242 kilometers in depth. I'll do a report on that one too later. So that would be about 154 miles below sea level. And you can see how far we are. Let me bring this out. From the Peru-Chile Atacama Trench. You can see here that it is on the western side of the buildup of these mountains. And there is an example of the Nazca plate, the oceanic crust, going under. And here we have the mountain range, the continental crust of the South American plate, and the heat that's coming up. Now in this area, the subduction is only about 2 to 10 centimeters a year. So 10 centimeters is almost 4 inches, 3.9 inches. So what are your thoughts? Put your comments down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. I'm also on Patreon if you wish to support my work, and thank you very much to all of you that do. I really appreciate it. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless you. Bye.